Stranger Things remains a global phenomenon. Why do you think that show has become such an important cultural reference point for so many people? Why is it the international sensation that it remains?
Well, I think it's very nostalgic to an 80s time period. I think the Duffer Brothers and Sean Levy put a lot into the production and the design and the storytelling and the feel. And if you wasn't in the 80s, if you were to take it in now, it makes you wish you were in the 80s. You know what I mean? As a child, it could resonate from the 8, 9-year-old to the 50, 60-year-old. And to have that kind of material, have that kind of impact on such a wide market, I think it's a testament of how pinpointed they were in telling that time period, because it's very attractive. For Stranger Things, I would say my favorite reference was probably that little green Pinto, the car, the Pinto car. I even have pictures of it on my phone, because when we were shooting the scenes and the car was in the house, out in front of the house, we were in the house, I just was so impressed by how immaculate and well put together this little green Pinto was, man. So yeah, that really stands out in my mind.
There's an attractive chemistry between you and David on that show. Can you talk a little bit about what makes him so great and how you felt, along with fans, about the somewhat climactic events of season 3?
Well, I'm not going to spoil anything for season 3. David Harbour is a phenomenal artist. He's very intelligent. He's very passionate. And I think I have some of those attributes also. So when we met and clicked and worked together, it came off in our chemistry and our relationship. Yeah, he's a phenomenal lead. I really feel that he should probably even get more recognition and more awards for his story presence in Stranger Things. But I'm pretty sure the kind of artist that he is, eventually they'll come. The memory from set that makes me crack the biggest smile is probably in season 1. And it really probably isn't a good memory for everybody, but for me it was a memory that made me crack a smile, because it showed me the phenomenal talent of these young kids, you know. And that was the scene when Will was being found in the water, and it was freezing cold out there. It was freezing. I mean, freezing. And the commitment that those kids put into finding Will, and the little girl who was the stunt double for Will, getting in that water as cold as it was, man, and so committed. Like, man, I often think about how her condition is after her committing herself to that scene, and then seeing how the children played off of it so perfectly and so emotionally and so connected. It just, man, it made me crack a smile, because it made me believe in the future, you know what I mean? And seeing these little artists, these kids, have this capacity to tell this story in such a brilliant way. So yeah, that made me crack a smile. I know it's strange, but that made me crack a smile.